Get up. Get up.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Turn around. I said turn around. There. Now, what do you say? What do you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
What an orphan.
I'm not an orphan. My mother and father let me know, saying that they love me and they're coming back for me.
That was 1922. This is 1933. Get up!
Cold mush.
Oh.
after your mush, she'll go straight to your sewing machine. So an order of dresses to finish if you have to work straight through to midnight.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Now line up.
Just thinking about tomorrow, clear the way the cobwebs in the sorrow.
get along before you catch your death cold.
Oh, I don't mind the cold.
Mississippi, capital M-I-double-S-I-double-S-I-double-P-I, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
say 8 or 9, 10. 11, yes, 11 would be perfect. And, oh, I almost forgot! Mr. Warbucks prefers redheaded children.
11, a redhead? Sorry, I don't think we have any orphans like that.
What about this child right here?
Oh, Annie? No, 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 you don't want her.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
I would love to!
You can have any orphan here, but not Annie.
Perhaps I should call the board of orphans and...
Well, well, if it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
Oh, boy!
And if you'll go get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
She don't have no coat!
Then we'll buy her one!
Oh, boy!
Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is outside.
Oh, boy! I can hardly believe it!
She can hardly believe it?
Hey, kids, I'm getting off for Christmas. All right, Tia.
Bye!
Someday I'll land in the nut house with all the nuts in the swirls. There I'll stay tucked away till the prohibition of freedom's done.
Bubbles,
I think.
And it comes into
Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
How was your flight from Chicago?
Not bad. Only took 11 hours. Grace?
Yes, sir?
Messages?
Mr. Warbucks, President Roosevelt wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get back to him tomorrow.
Mr. Warbucks?
All right, good to see you all again.
Sir?
Drake, dismiss the staff.
Yes, sir.
And Grace. Fill me your notebook. Who's that?
Oh, this is Eddie, Mr. Warbucks. The orphan who will be with us for Christmas.
That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphans.
So I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose she'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
I'm just Annie, Mr. Warbucks, sir. I haven't got any last names. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Not at all. Couldn't be happier. Grace, we'll start with the figures on the iron ore shipments from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It is
her
first night here, sir.
Well, Annie, I guess we ought to do something fun on your first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one!
Then you'll go to the Roxy, and then an ice cream soda at Rumpelmayer's, and a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Collie!
Grace, forget about the dictation for tonight. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
It's just that, well, I thought you were gonna take me.
Oh, no, I'm afraid I'm far too busy tonight.
Aw, gee.
Now, Annie. I've just been away for 6 weeks. And when a man is running a multi-million dollar corporation...
I know. It's all right, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake!
Yes, sir?
Good out, Coates.
Aw, yay!
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Which car will you be on, sir?
The Duesenberg. No, wait. This child's been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk? To the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell those bus fumes. There's no air like the air of New York. Come on, you slowpokes. We gotta get to the Roxy before the prices change.
NYC, the shimmer of Times Square. The bolts,
the feet,
the drive. NYC, you might say that I'm square. But wow, I go a lot.
The city's bright as a candy dark day. It leaks, it tilts, it breaks.
To think that I've lived here all my life, I've never seen these things.
And why see the whole world keeps coming?
My boss, my train.
Yeah, for
States they love the best. The California pays big for their hearts. The family comes a jest to NYC. Tomorrow a penthouse that's way up high.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over.
God, I hope not. Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Warbucks sat up with Annie already?
On the contrary. This has to be signed and sent back to the Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that he wants a doctor. Would you excuse me for a moment, please? Got any more wonderful news? Merry Christmas, Miss Hannigan.
Hi, sis. Long time no see.
Rooster! They finally let you out of prison. What was you in for this time?
Some old geezer said I swindled him out of 1,100 bucks.
Well, why do you say that?
Because the rooster swindled him out of 1,100 bucks.
Sis, I'd like you to meet my friend from...
Jersey City!
Rooster, do me a favor. Get out of here.
So... Who's that blondie I bumped into when I come in? It looked like she had a couple of dollars.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
Z? Oliver Warbucks? Annie, one of the orphans from here, is getting adopted by him. Ugh, call me orphan.
Yeah, living in the lap of luxury while the two hand beacons ended up on the skids. It ain't clear how we scrounge for 3 or 4 bucks. While she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fast.
name that little bitch.
Where does that put us?
Give you one guess. Yes! Easy Street. Easy Street. Any home like it. Yes, oh, me. Yes, oh, me.
Yes. Yes, Mr. President. No, I'm not asking for your help, but I'm telling you you've got to do something. All right, we'll talk about it on...
Friday.
Listen, Mr. President, why don't we bury the hatchet and you come over with Mrs. Roosevelt for supper, Christmas Eve? You will? Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's.
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and tell her I want to adopt her.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. for you.
Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father. If he has to put everyone in this organization onto this job, if he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Amy, give me your locket.
But, Mr. Warbucks,
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace that and find out who bought it.
Okay, and maybe they should have my locket too.
You watch, Amy. You might be meeting your mother and father in a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh boy, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
Oh, you won't.
host to America's favorite radio program, The Oxen Hour of Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. And good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Bert Healy. It's nice to be here.
Now, Mr. Warbucks, I understand you have something to tell the folks at home about little Annie here.
Yes, Bert Healy.
I am now conducting a coast-to-coast, nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove they are Annie's parents.
Wow!
So Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Bert Healy, or write to Oliver Warbucks, care of the station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Austin. Yet this is your old softie, Mama Healy's boy Bert, saying, until next time, same week, same station, good night.
Annie, on the radio, coast to coast, she's famous.
I wish I was on the radio.
Me too. Who wants to be on a dumb old radio?
I do. So, for all the hours and smiles, this is for Healy saying... Hey ho, man! Hey, Dapper Dan! You both got your smile, but brother, you're not fully dressed without a smile. So, for all the hours of smiles, this is for Healy saying. Hey ho, man! Hey, Dapper Dan! You both got your smile, but brother.
$50,000. Can you imagine what I could do with $50,000?
Excuse me, sir. Was you working here, Olivia?
Yeah.
Well, we had terrible troubles back then. I had to leave a baby here on the front stoop.
A little girl. Our Annie.
Your Annie's parents? I can't believe it. Where'd you say you come from again?
A little farm. Up in Canada. With lots of ducks and geese and roosters. Ha, gotcha, sis.
Rooster, I never would have known it was you in 100 years.
Fooled you, Aggie, and we're going to fool Warbucks, too.
Get ourselves 15,000 big ones.
But we need your help for details about Annie that can help pull this thing off.
What's in it for me?
Three-way split.
Half.
Okay, 25 grand each, but we got to do this fast. Get the kid, get the money, and get out of town.
The kid's the problem. What are we going to do with her afterward?
No problem. When I want something that disappears, it disappears. For good. But we got to do this fast. Get the 50 grand, blow this crummy town, and then Lil and me will meet you.
Where? Oh.
sir, me. Yes, sir, me. Yes, sir, me. Easy Street.
Yeah.
think of you. Yesterday was an awful day.
You can say that again.
Yesterday was an awful day.
But that's
not that.
That's that.
I'm more of a clown.
I'm richer than Midas. But nothing on earth
could ever be
Midas. This is
wonderful news.
Drink champagne.
Yes, sir.
We must celebrate because we just had the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has finally found her parents. I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge. Annie!
God, I've lost her. I've lost Annie.
Sir, I have the strangest feeling that I've seen on Mr. Mudge somewhere, and he is not who he said he is.
Then we won't give up till we're certain.
But how?
I'll go straight to the top, to the President of the United States, even if he is a Democrat.
Thank you.
Mr. Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Mr. President.
Merry Christmas, Annie. Early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. He succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Munch.
No, dear. David and Margaret Bennett.
What?
Annie.
Your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
I mean, I am an orphan. After all...
Are you okay, Annie?
Yes, because I know they love me, and they would have come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie, much.
And I love you, too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could have easily been forged, but nobody knew about the locket except for us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Hey, kids!
Annie! Hi, Annie!
Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here, I'd know you anywhere.
Let me introduce you to everyone. You know my secretary, Miss Farrell. This is the President of the United States. And here is my butler, Bree.
Look, kids, there's presents for all of us.
Yay! Mr. Warbucks, this has just come from the FBI.
Now it all fits together.
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
We're not going to bother on Christmas and all, but we come to pick up Annie and the check.
Ah, yes, the check. Here it is, $50,000 certified.
Certified. Hey, so the order of... The jig is up?
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Push. Turn them over.
Yes, sir.
Take the halls with bells of
Hannigan. And I think you'll be finding this woman at their accomplice.
I've never seen these people till yesterday.
Dad, come off it, Aggie. Annie, tell them how good and nice I always was to you.
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but... Remember the one thing you always taught me, never tell a lie.
Rat! This Hannigan is gone for good!
Hooray!
And you'll never have to work again.
Hooray!
Yes, girls, and perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. A new deal.